was lived throughout his life as an atheist. At the end, somehow a small accident happened in his life. He has fallen from a cliff. He is just holding a tree, the root of a tree, and shouting for help. And he saw that root is also slowly coming down. When he saw he is going to die, he thought, anyhow I am going to die, why not give a small chance to God? Why not give a small trial? He shouted with all his being, O God, throughout my life I never believed you. Now I'll believe you. Please somehow save me. Save me, I'll believe you. God from above, he told, all right, I will save you. Don't worry. Let go your hand. I'll hold you. I'll take care of you. Immediately he shouted, is there anybody else who can save me? Is there anybody else who can do something for me? Whenever you relate with the divine through fear, you end up in the same way. Neither through greed nor through fear you can relate with the divine. You may try your best, but relationship can never happen. One captain and his subordinates, three persons, all the four were traveling in a ship. Suddenly the storm has attacked the sea. The ship has started shaking. They felt totally insecure. What to do? Captain started praying fervently. Oh God, somehow save us. If you save us, we'll stop smoking. But God is not listening for the prayer. Still, the ship is shaking. After 10 minutes, he started praying, God, please somehow save us. We'll stop drinking. No answer. Still, it is shaking. It is becoming only worse. He started shouting, oh God, please save us somehow. We will stop womanizing. The subordinate colleague told, keep quiet, don't shout much. I think a small island is seen. We could see small island. Please go, don't go to that extent. A small island is seen. Through fear, when you relate with the divine, you can never relate. Next, through worries, Manipuraka. You try to relate with the divine for the sake of your peace, for the sake of your silence. Now you will enter into a new phase. You will be able to relate. Fear and greed will never open the door to the divine. Asking for peace will just allow you near that vicinity. Of course, just if you ask for the peace, you cannot enter into the temple of God, but you can enter that vicinity. In a way, it's like you will not have the citizenship, but like green card. You will have a green card. Asking for peace is like a green card. You will be under the trial. You will be under the watch. But a good step. You will be allowed to park, but not to enter into the temple. When you ask for the next step, creativity, the throat. Through creativity you can relate with the God. Relating with the God through creativity, now only First, you will be entering into the space of the divine. That is why you can always see through art, through dance, through poems, you can relate with the divine very well. Then, through offering your money. I have seen in India, people who pour all their wealth on the temples. They will be pouring the wealth, getting only the blessings of priest, never the God. Person who pours his being, his emotion, his creativity, person who writes poems, person who creates dances, person who creates painting for the God, I have seen always they relate with the divine, they get the blessings. Whenever you pour the wealth, you get the blessings of the priest. Whenever you pour your being, you get the blessings of God. I have always seen people having great satisfaction and blessings in our ashram also. When they come and do some service, creativity, some way of spending the time, they go with more satisfaction, more benefit, and more result than the persons who pour the wealth. Of course, when you pour the wealth with humility and humbleness, you spend the time also, you spend the heart also. Whenever you put only the money, not the heart, you try to relate to the divine, through greed and the fear. Only when you put your time, only when you put your creativity, only when you do something for the divine, you try to relate to the divine through the plane of creativity. You can always see throughout the ages, in the spiritual histories, not only in Hindu tradition, in all the tradition, the spiritual figures, if you take their life, if you take and read their backgrounds, the person who built the temple, spending his whole country, he will never be considered as a spiritual figure. But the person who went there and sang 10 lines on that Lord, he will become a spiritual figure. In South India, there are saints who went to the temples. They spent all their life going around, seeing all the temples and chanting stotras or singing songs. The person who built the temple, spending his whole life, whole money, whole energy, whole country, he is never considered as a spiritual person. But the person who just visited the temple and sang about the Shiva, sang about that Muruga, few words, few lines, he is considered as a spiritual figure. The person who built the church is never cared, but person who prayed, he was always considered as a spiritual figure. So creativity can open the first step for you to the divine. Then comes ultimately the ego. Of course, through ego, you try to relate with the divine. Two things you need to understand. When I say ego, you should understand two things. The very idea ego itself should not be condemned. The way in which you use your ego, only in that way, either it should be praised or condemned. The ego itself cannot be condemned. Ramakrishna says, if you have the ego that I am the servant of God, it will never harm anybody. That type of ego can never disturb anybody. A small story from Bhagavatam, you need to understand. Once a saint was living in a forest. His son was also living with him. The saint has gone out to take bath and do meditation. At that time, one king came to ashram for the sake of blessing. The son of the rishi was son of the saint was staying there. He asked the king, "What for you came?" The king said, "I have a skin disease throughout my body. I wanted the blessing of the rishi, sage, so I came here." Son said, "Chant Krishna's name 3 times. Chant Krishna's name 3 times. I think he started chanting as as soon as I told, it has started chanting. Chant Krishna's name 3 times. Then you will get rid of the disease. The king also chanted Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. And miraculously the disease has disappeared. He has gone. In East, the prayer healing is very popular. Of course, just 20 years ago, the West has understood the prayer can do miracles. I read in a book written by the Deepak Chopra. He says, 20 years ago, they did a research on 100 patients. They took up 100 patients from different culture and from different background. They did research how prayer can help a man to come out of his disease. They say all the 100 cases proved at least 50 to 100% from 50, minimum of 50%, maximum of 100%, patients recover from after surgery, after any surgery or after any problem. 50 to 100% they recover just by prayer. Of course, report is amazing, but he says the study has proved the power of prayer on a patient. It is not that the patient and the man who prays should be even related in any way. The discovery says one or two amazing things. The patient and the person who prays, there is no need even they should have any relationship. And the third thing, when a man prays, in his own system, so much of change happens, his immune system gets strengthened. Whenever you pray for somebody, not only he gets healed, your immune system gets strengthened. He says, prayer is a journey into consciousness. Thousands of years ago, East knows the truth. Just 20 years ago, West has discovered by the research. The scientist, the persons who recorded this research, after a much reluctant feeling, after the long discussion, even after the long discussion, they were reluctant to publish the report because it is something totally new. How can you simply say a prayer can do so much in the system? But the study says it is true, no other way. Once they publish the report, then only the prayer has gained very big popularity in the West. Of course, now the West also understands the prayer can do miracles for healing, for recovery of the patients, recovery of anybody. Anyhow, the son of the saint, son of the rishi told the king, chant 3 times Krishna's name. And you will be healed. The king chanted and got healed and went away. Father came. As soon as the father came back to the ashram, son was too pride of the miracle done by him. He went and told the father, "Father, like this, the king of this country came. He had a skin disease. I told him, chant Krishna's name 3 times. He chanted. He got healed. The skin disease disappeared. He has gone back to the palace. He will come afterwards to take your blessings. He has gone back." He was too proud, too happy, too joyful that he has performed a big miracle. As soon as the father heard this, he was totally entered into the mood of anger. And he just looked at the son and told, "Fool, what you understood? Only this much you understood my teachings. For ordinary skin disease, you made that fellow to chant Krishna's name 3 times. 3 times. He can cross the whole life. He can become enlightened. He can go to directly moksha. For ordinary skin disease, you made him chant 3 times. Then what is your understanding about spirituality? Only once is more than enough. If it is a disease, there is no need even for him to chant. You just chant. If he listens, that is enough." And in his mood of anger, he curses the son. "You have no faith on Krishna's name." And finally, the son goes to do more tapas, to understand, to have more faith in Lord's name. And he was sent to the forest to continue his tapas. "You cannot be now accepted into the home. Go and do tapas and understand and come." This story can show, even through ego you can relate. The rishi has got solid ego, is angry, but with a different reason, with a different understanding. The gopis used to tell the Krishna's beloveds that even Yama cannot touch us, even Yama cannot do anything to us, because we have touched the feet of divine, we have touched the Lord's feet. When the Krishna's feet touches our head, Brahma's handwriting disappears. They say when the Lord's feet touches, Brahma's handwriting is erased or wiped. It is changed. The ego attached to the divine, Ramakrishna will tell, vidyahankara, the ego of divine. If you feel you are son of divine, your being is related to divine, the ego also can lead you to the divine. The next step, it can make you relate with the divine. Finally, your Sahasrara Chakra, the ultimate energy center. If you understand the emotions, each emotion I am explaining is related to one own chakra. Muladhara, greed. Swadhisthana, fear. Manipuraga, worry. Anahata, attention. Vishuddhi, creativity. Anya, ego. The Sahasrara, bliss. Bliss can directly open the gate to the divine, door to the divine. Bliss can directly put you into the divine. When I say bliss, I mean you are being in love. You need to understand, love has got 2 dimensions. Love as an act and love as a being. Love as an act is a love as you understand. As you understand, a normal love. Love as a being is bliss. Love, when it relates with others, it is love. It's relationship. When it is by itself, it is bliss.